Welcome to a totally not done thing before, a kit tier list of DVN. Now, the reason why I'm making this is because, first of all, I was just in the mood to make it, and my channel, my rules, go cry about it. But more so the fact that there's been some changes. So Block has updated a good handful of things, which changes the meta of classes a little bit. And my skill level has also made me learn some things. This tier list will be based off of Siege, Masochist, and Hell only. No epilogue, no attrition, no difficulty below Masochist. So, yeah. I'm not going to waste too much time. I'll get straight into it. So, here first we have Assault. I'm going to go ahead and put it as C tier immediately for being very average. I've learned a lot of things about Assault. So, Assault is a good all-round class, has a good, two good passives of fire rate increase and a thicker health pool. Combat rifle got some changes. So combat rifle has a slightly decreased fire rate, which is not really noticeable, but more so it deals more damage. So 20 damage per shot on rifles, unless you're doing harpoon, it's 25, which is really good. Harpoon got a bug fix where now the final shot will actually pull the enemy in and won't just make you reload for nothing. Oh yeah, you're mine now, buddy. Bolter's kind of bugged with the hit registration, so it's very, very not fun to use with the grenades right now because you can't land hits half the time. And same goes for enemies a lot of times. But combat rifle update is very noticeable, and they're actually quite enjoyable to use now. But the issue is first person now has a weird spray pattern. Block decided to nerf first person for some inexplicable reason. I don't know why in Block. I'm going to tell you right now, not a single person has liked it that I know of, and we're asking you to revert it. Why would you nerf first person? Something that's already considered not optimal. I don't know what you're talking about, man. This is great. What? This is really good. Yeah. Oh, I've landed two hits. Oh, I'm going to die. Yep. Is what it is. Now we also have we have grenade launcher and shovel. So you have basic melee and assault is pretty versatile. Being able to take on a pretty aggressive play styles or more gunning backline support. So bolter and rally is a very good combo or harpoon and overcharger to really frontline. Grenade launcher is good for dealing with mech units and heavier units like if shielders, you can take them out the earlier waves because, I mean, if you're on masochist, ammo's not that important, but gunners, you can stun them. Overall, assault is a very good class. I think assault being so good belongs in C tier and is one of the worst classes in the game because the other classes are just simply better in most cases. So even though I said it's one of the worst classes, it's still a really good class. There's like actually nothing wrong with it. It's actually probably one of the most balanced classes of anything because it's extraordinarily powerful if used right, but it requires a bit of an expensive kit to gain that kind of power. And it's super beginner friendly and it's super veteran friendly. It's just a good class. I think it's a class that anyone can appreciate. But overall, we're gonna move on to medic. This kit is definitely very mixed amongst people. It's seen as like a mandatory for a lot of people and also not. So passive right off the bat, I think would be kind of eh for most classes, good but not like amazing. But because medic is focused on supporting others, medic can spend less time trying to support himself because he'll be able to heal on his own. You have a medical bow, which comes with upgrades that really vary in support. Vita bows, if you want to like say buff and revive mangled people, do some AoE healing, very more support oriented. Or recurve is if you want more on the fly usage. It's very handy to use as you can revive at any range. The bullet velocity removes a lot of drop, making it easier to aim with, and it does a lot of damage, making it a good weapon overall. It's cheaper in ammo too. Shovel, don't need to explain much there. And med kit, self-preservation, upgrade to lifeline if you want to save a lot of ammo and healing. I really recommend it. Mercy Kill, if you hate yourself. Funny thing is that I know a lot of medics want to buy upgrade their medical bows. 17 reserves for the upgrade is not worth it unless you're doing hell, because you have to get Vita for mangled deaths, but you don't need to upgrade your bow at all. Like, it all revives the same, and if you're having to revive mangled people constantly, then I'm sorry that your team sucks and are dying to cloakers, one of the easiest enemies in the game. Actually, you just don't know what it's like dying to the hardest enemy in the game, pal. As a fellow scout myself, you see, I know a lot about scout. That's why I said masochist in hell, because you'd expect people on these difficulties to be pretty skilled enough to not. And I recurve is good for, damage, but why wouldn't you just spend three extra reserves for rocket stormer, which does a lot more killing potential? I mean, it's one of, if not the best weapons in the game right now. Rocket stormer just does everything really, really well, especially since Bullock decided to buff it for some reason. Yeah, I'm sorry, but I don't think Bullock has the best sense of probably one of the worst senses of balance. I mean, she's done some good stuff, but her sense of balance is really questionable at times. I mean, she did nerf it towards bosses, but that was mainly it. I don't know, but either way, medic is a purely support class, which means that you're not going to be very damage focused. But considering the fact that we're thinking of teams a lot, medic is at least going to be a B tier, because it's more essential in a team than an assault. An assault is not going to be necessary at all. Medic is actually relatively important. A lot of cases, if you have a team that's good enough, you might not need a medic. If you're doing hell, I don't think a medic is super optional unless your team's really good, which we've had that before. Especially if you're doing duos, then you're gonna have to learn how to play without a medic, and that's very hard. But overall, medic is definitely above average, because it's very, overall, just very important to team comps in a lot of cases. Still, it's probably wondering, like, it's not A tier, what? Next up, we go to Recon. Now, might be a little biased because I am a Recon main. Funny thing is, I actually used to be a medic main, and then I was an assault main, so I started off as a medic main, which was kind of short-lived. Jumped to assault, and then now I'm at Recon. Recon's not the best class in the game, though, I'll tell you that much. Recon has a really handy and convenient reload passive for your DMR, and a very powerful enemy reduction accuracy deal. Now, a lot of people don't know how this actually works. Basically, an enemy spread is increased by 50%. No, that's not how that works. Sorry, it's there is doubled, because their accuracy is cut in half. So their spread is basically doubled. That's insane. Now, this means that snipers will still be 100% accurate, because 2 times 0 is still 0, because they have a spread of 0. So that's, you need to, if it, an enemy has to have spread to begin with for it to work. So Achilles, snipers, tranquilizers, they'll still hit you. Tanks have spread. It works on them. Infantry works on them. Shielders are hit scan, so no, it does not work on them. Saboteurs, yes, but they're close range, meaning a lot of times you're not really going to notice it. Platform and placements, I'm not sure. Platform and placements is a weird one, but it doesn't matter, because they're not going to shoot until you're like too close to them anyways. It really encourages you to be far away from the enemies. If you're far away, you're probably like almost never going to get hit by most enemies, meaning your only enemy are your own kind, that being snipers. Now, that being said, in its kit you have DMR, SMG, machete, and teleporter. Three of these items are amazing. One of them is not, that being SMG. The only use for SMG is maybe emergency enemies getting too close, but that's what your machete's for, because it literally one-shots most enemies. I use SMG to tap fire enemies sometimes, and if I use Torque Blade on a shielder, it'll have a little bit of HP, so I'll tap fire once with SMG. That's like its main usage. But alternatively, you really are going to be focusing on this DMR right here. So teleporters is extremely important for support, honestly mitigating actual other support classes like medics a lot of times. But then again, a medic can also buy a teleporter. But having this teleporter on your team, it First of all, this is necessary for hell mode. It's insane how important a teleport is. For masochist gameplay, not as much, but it definitely makes the difference. Base machete is cheap, but you can get Torque Blade, which is a very good weapon, and it's just nice to have. But the DMR is where we start to really cook. So you have two playstyles you can go with. If you're doing Hell, you're going to do Armor Pillar and Torque Blade, because the other one is not really as recommended due to ammo efficiency. But the other method is Gift of Fire and Torque Blade. Not Torque Blade. Armor RPG, I'm sorry. Gift of Fire got a buff that actually makes it very powerful. The bullet drop is not much stronger than a DMR's, and landing a headshot instantly puts a puddle, killing a lot of things. And to make up for the lack of mech damage, that's why you buy RPG. Two reserves cheaper than Armor Pillar and Torque Blade, actually. But the only thing is that it might not be as effective in certain cases. Armor Pillar, I know a lot of people were like, oh, Armor Pillar got gutted. Yes, its damage to mech units is halved now. However, the other buffs that it received might actually make Armor Pillar in its best it's ever been, in a sense, while also not being completely brain dead like it used to be. Because now it pierces almost anything, like ricochet plating and all of it, meaning you can get some pretty sick lineups with platforms and tanks, being able to kill them almost just as fast as before. And hey, 1k per 1% ammo is still pretty good, it's just not very quick. But I mean, it's essential for Hermes, which Hermes is one of the, if not the most powerful bosses in the game. No, I'm not sure what I'm talking about. This is fair. Practically meta, which is why Recon also being having a cheap kit with one of the most expensive items in the game. I'm gonna have to definitely put an A tier for being an excellent damage dealer and support, being able to be decent at killing fodder units, great at support, and very powerful at taking down priority units. Recon can kind of do it all, even despite the drawbacks it's recently had. Next up, we got Engineer. Oh my god. So my last tier list, I put Engineer at C tier because two things. First of all, Engineer got some crazy buffs directly and indirectly. And alternatively as well as I also was not very good at Engineer back then. Engineer right now, high A tier. Engineer is one of the best classes in the game right now. Very, very powerful. You have a good two decent passives, really cheap ammo prices, meaning you can be reckless as hell with a lot of your items, and you can buy charges. Typically, with a good loadout, you're not going to be buying charges. I mean, that's just not optimal. But it's still good if it's there if you need it. You have a fat kit of shotgun, machete, RPG, PDC, and barrier. All five of these items are potentially very useful, minus shotgun. Shotgun is still pretty bad, other than the fact that it has a few good niches, like being able to take down bosses like Sparta and Daedalus. So it's good for frontlining. But when it comes to most units, like if a Saboteur is rushing you, just throw a machete or use your Rocket Stormer. I mean, that's the thing, too. Rocket Stormer can outperform shotgun right now. Rocket Stormer is a little bit too meta right now. Shotgun is still pretty eh. Don't try to justify Sprinter Streak. You're wasting reserves and you're unable to buy jetpack when you need it. This kit can do it all though. It is an arsenal kit, not an engineer. If you play it like an engineer where you sit there and you camp your PDC, you're gonna wonder why you're struggling when you choose to sit there and do nothing. What you do is you want to get like something like you could get Torque Blade and Shockwave, or alternatively you can just get Rocket Stormer, which is way cheaper, but Torque Blade and Shockwave is really good. Shockwave got some major bug fixes and its range increased to 1.2k, so I think it's 1.2k. It got a bit, pretty noticeable range buff. Shockwave is a very good alternative now. And like I said, can't ever complain about machete. It's a great cheap free ammo saving weapon, especially when you upgrade it to Torque Blade. In your PDC, free damage, which you can upgrade to Governor. You got Barrier, which Barrier and its upgrades are pretty trash, except for Hallucinator. Hallucinator is very powerful. Baits the whole fields to whatever location you want. It's like a very, very powerful whistle that you can control its positioning. and it's good with engineer's passive, so the ammo consumption won't really bother you that much. Then you get like proxy to store up damage from like your rocket stormer and your turrets. And let me tell you, there's a new meta with engineer. You gotta try engineer with rallying cry. Oh my god. PC's filling up. Look, full rally charge already. Constant, dude, engineer's got it all. You got insane fodder killing potential, major targeting, like taking down major units such as bosses and mechs. You got incredible support with potential like rallying cry, proxy, hallucinator. Engineer's got it all. Engineer is the only reason it's not an S tier is because it actually takes a good amount of knowledge and effort to actually use it. Engineer is definitely not like just a freebie class to use. It takes skill and it takes a lot of management. But it's a very, very good like class with the proxy buffs, rocket stormer buffs for some reason, shockwave buffs. PDC got nerfed. Not really, it got bug fixed, so it does very little damage to bosses, but still good at chipping, and you have governor for worst case scenario. Hallucinator bug, I think. I don't know if it's a buff or a bug, but regardless, engineer is cooking. Next up, we got the scout. Yeah, fight me. The only reason it's not an F tier is because F tier implies that the class is completely unusable, but this class is not very far from it. If you're an experienced player who's been playing the game for a long time, you're probably not surprised by this. You probably know, like, yeah, I mean, most longtime scout mains know that this class is bad, yet they still play anyways because they enjoy it. This class is shouldn't it's not even really like much of a kit at all. You have a passive of, ooh, 25% faster walk speed. It's nice. It's not amazing. It's an okay passive, but there's it doesn't offer a lot. Like that's not like game changing. It's really noticeable with like jetpacks, not aero rig, terminal and base jetpack because you'll get 25% more distance coverage. That is pretty good. I'll give it that. Beyond that, though, the only benefit you get is that passive and an early jetpack. You see, the reason why getting an early jetpack implies that it'd be good is because jetpack is expensive. You think you're saving a lot of reserves. You're not, though, because you have to spend a major amount of reserves trying to fill in the rest of your kit. I mean, you get Akimbos, which, I'm sorry, are not good weapons. They deal 26 damage per shot and heal. Sounds good, except for the fact that the hit registration and accuracy is rough. Not to mention the ammo consumption of 0.1% ammo per shot. Dear God. You might think, like, oh, Voltic's got like a bunch of new benefits of accuracy, and it's got like the jetpack like hovering thing, and it's AoE, and I'm like, just get Rocket Stormer, dude. Rocket Stormer, it does way more, being able to take down mech units and bosses very effectively. It has crazy splash damage, completely mitigating the use of Voltic's chaining. And the accuracy, I mean, it's Rocket Stormer. There is no spread. You can literally guide the rocket. And the jetpack hovering feature, who cares about it? Like you're subbing that out for a weapon that does so much more. Like, okay. And then Gunslinger. Gunslinger actually did get some buffs. So Gunslinger can do up to 40 damage per shot, which I'm not gonna lie is bad, but the trying to land those hits with the requirements of that is kind of rough. Now, the buffs for Gunslinger is that the fact that it is 40% on hit instead of 20%. And it also has a passive feature where if you get a kill, does not matter if you're using, you can use any weapon. If you just get a kill in general, you'll gain a 5 second speed boost at 20%. That's a nice buff. That's a good buff. I still don't think it justifies spending 15 reserves for it. But if you have it, I definitely think buying it's not a bad idea. Like it's almost objectively better than basic chemo, and it's definitely like gonna be the passive's gonna be like very handy. But I mean, other than that, you're not getting much of a kit at all. And Aero Rig has no synergy with this kit at all. Like, there's no reason to buy Aero at all with Scout because there's no Akimbo upgrades that work with it. I mean, Voltic only activates its powerful buffs when you're hovering. I know it says airborne. By the way, it's only when you're jetpack gliding that the Voltic benefits actually apply. So it's completely useless with Aero. And Aero has, there's nothing else in its kit, like 25% faster walk speed. Aero does not scale with speed like jetpacks or terminal does. Scout, that's the issue, is it doesn't have a kit. It has virtually nothing. And yes, even though jetpacks is expensive and you get it early on, you're gonna be wanting to buy like a melee and a, maybe like RPG and a bunch of other things, thus spending a lot of reserves. I found that with my optimal kit of getting Overcharger and Rocket Swarmer, I only get terminal one wave earlier than I would with any other class. Which, most of the time, with any other class, when I need to buy jetpack and its upgrades, I'm already able to by the time I actually need it. You don't need a jetpack on like wave one, two, or three. You don't need it at those times. Like, what? So like, it, just admit you enjoy Scout because it's fun. It's not a good class, though. I've already broke down why it's not. You can try to argue with me, and you know, maybe you can make up some good points. But overall, like, look at it compared to Engineer. Engineer has so much more of a kit. Or compared to Assault. Assault is like Scout but better. You get extra health, so you're actually tankier. And you get more fire rate, so you synergize with other weapons. You get like a thing that can actually damage mech units and stun. You actually have a melee. Like, why does Scout not get a melee? It's a frontliner. But yeah, that's Scout. I'm not gonna yap anymore about it. But finally, last but not least, this guy. I was tempted to actually put this A tier. Not really, I was actually tempted to put Engineer at S tier. Specialist is, yeah, it has three exclusive items. No other kit gets that treatment. And each of those three exclusive items are amazing. It's not like where Recon gets an exclusive item and it's SMG. Engineer gets no exclusive items. Scout gets a key bow. I mean, medical bow is like a highlight of medic's kit, yes. Grenade launcher is good, its upgrades are not. But when you get the spec, you get three passives. Sorry, four, because you also have a scrap passive, remember that. Like, these just need to get removed. You have a weaker assault and medic passive. You have the base burst rifle is one of the best, like, regular guns in the game. It consumes no real ammo, so you can spam away and it heals you. It has a long barrel, which means that you could shoot over edges super easily. The upgrades are incredibly amazing. Stonewall is like has like 70 million debuffs and only one benefit, that being the fact that it can deal a lot more damage. But that a lot more damage is noticeable enough to justify getting Stonewall. Steelforge, I don't need to explain why Steelforge is amazing. You get a tablet that gives you like literal nukes, knockouts, a free sentry on legs that does 50 damage per orb. You have a pseudo totem of undying with a motion hider, which can literally save your team as like a secondary resort for dealing with Achilles and reviving people. I mean, it's foolish to say that this class is not literally the meta. I mean, it doesn't even cost anything to use most of its items. It's perfect. I mean, artillery, it had some slight nerfs. Okay, so artillery went from costing 90 scrap to 105. That's 15 scrap more. Who cares? It's still a nuke. It's brain dead. Like, it should just get removed. What's the other nerf? Oh, sorry. Ranger's got two nerfs, by the way. It has a 30-second lifespan. How much do you think a ranger can kill in 30 seconds? Quite a bit, and it's only 50 scrap to deploy one. Rangers also got a pretty massive damage nerf to bosses. I think it does like 5 damage to bosses. Or no, it does a very little. It is pretty small, but like still, like it's being able to chip at bosses for freeze. Pretty good, and it still can solo Prometheus. And you know, that's a lot, because Prometheus is, in one of my opinion, one of the most powerful bosses in the game. I rank Prometheus probably the fourth most powerful boss, with the top three being Achilles, Hermes, and Daedalus, because Prometheus, he's just better than Trident and Sparta. That's the way I look at it. Because those two bosses are kind of easy, I'm not gonna lie. But yeah. Specialist is meta. Scout is dog. Yeah. We're at the segment where I would give my opinion for reworking said classes. First of all, Scout could get like a passive where maybe he could automatically highlight or outline things within a certain range so he could see sabs and landmines or see things through walls. Kind of like the epilogue, like highlighting effect, but it's on his end. And maybe if he pinged things, they would also become highlighted towards like all players. So that would make him really good for support. Alternatively, Scout could probably use some benefits to its kit. First of all, if it actually had some items, like I'd say give it like maybe like shovel and RPG, or even just shovel, dude. If you give it those items, it would be pretty good. Fix Akimbo's like hit registration, and it would be cool. Like, what if Akimbo had a feature where if you press Q, you can alternate between dual and single pistols, so you can like you can press Q to only hold one pistol, but in turn, it's a lot. You trade out a lot more accuracy, a tighter spread, and tap fire in exchange for fire rate. And also, give Akimbo's a magazine system so it's not 0.1% ammo per shot. Maybe like I want it to be like if anything, roughly 0.05, half of what it is now. Because if you cut it in half, then I'd say it's actually pretty not bad in efficiency. Also, Gunslinger as an upgrade, I actually think is potentially really good. Voltic's just weird, though. I personally think bring back like Bloodshot. Because if Bloodshot would actually be really good, because Bloodshot does more damage and has more accuracy, meaning it's actually more worth your ammo. And it recharges jetpack charges, meaning you can become that would actually make Scout really viable because then you could not even have terminal and you could have a lot more mobility time. Because that's the whole focus of Scout is its mobility. But it just doesn't really feel like it emphasizes enough on that. Especially since it doesn't even have a true mobility weapon. Like Specialist has its tablet, you know, other classes have melees. Sure, Scout has Akimbo, but Akimbo doesn't make you sprint like a melee does. It makes you run at like defib speed, you know? It's lesser. I don't know. Scout's just really weak. Assault is a good class, but I would definitely say, please, for love of God, fix the grenade launcher upgrades. They're horrid. Probably some of the worst weapons in the game. It's crazy that the base grenade launcher is actually just so much better. Fix the bolter bug. And then, honestly, with that, like, I'd say, like, assault is fine. Medic, I feel like, is pretty good, honestly. Yeah, medic's. There's nothing wrong with medic. Recon. I would definitely say that it'd be nice if you could actually make SMG like worthwhile. Its upgrades are pointless to get, honestly. Oh wait, sorry, make medics boast like 16 reserves instead of 17. 17 is just a little too much, I feel like. But recon, be cool if its SMGs were actually worthwhile to use. I mean, other than that, like I mean recon's not a bad class. It's just that SMG is so eh. And it's not like if you like made SMG actually somewhat decent, that it would make recon too overpowered, like, because recon's power point is being far away. Engineer is honestly really good. I wouldn't change a whole lot, but I still think shotgun needs a buff. Like, it needs way tighter spread, all the variants do. Hall sweeper needs to cost less ammo per shot, not more. It makes no sense that it's a spam weapon, it costs more. In general, I feel like the shotgun upgrades could be cheaper too. Like Sprinter Streak is like what, 15 reserves? 5 reserves more, and I could just get a jetpack. It'd be cool to like what if Sprinter Streaks also had like heal and kill? I know Cozy said something like that, and I thought that was actually kind of cool. Nerf Rocket Stormer a bit. I don't know why Rocket Stormer is so it's way too powerful, way too meta. Replace Stone Edge with like I don't know like a force field that has like a health pool. Because I don't even know what Stone Edge is trying to be. It's weird. Stupid. Replace mads, remove them or something. Or just make them better. Engineer's not like a weak class though. It has some bad upgrades. Specialist needs a lot of nerfs. I don't even want to try to like get into that and explain what nerfs it would need, but Specialist almost needs like a kind of a rework. You don't want to gut it completely, but you want it kind of really screws off the balance of the game. Like, I'm sorry, artillery needs removed completely. It is stupidly brain dead and overpowered. Like, it's literally just click to win. But yeah, that's it for my tier list. That's it for my reviews, and fuck off.